Thank you for holding this important hearing and for inviting me here today to discuss the proposed 20% national reduction to the Amtrak Police Department. I'm truly honored for this opportunity to speak on the important subject of great concern for the American public and its transportation infrastructure, most specifically the millions of Americans that ride on Amtrak trains every year, as well as the thousands of dedicated Amtrak employees. I, as well as my fellow officers, believe this to be a matter that has the potential to substantially impact our nation's security and safety. My name is William Gonzalez. I'm the president of the Amtrak Labor Committee, and the Labor Committee is a duly recognized union for the 400-plus brave and distinguished members of the Amtrak Police Department. Amtrak police are responsible for protecting over 300 daily trains covering 21,000 route miles in 46 states. The Amtrak system is critical to our nation's economy and mobility. Despite Amtrak's substantial network and recent ridership records, the current police force is currently comprised of only approximately 440 positions, which includes the commanders. When you deduct the management, the total working police force is comprised of approximately 424 actual patrolmen, which is down from the 492 patrol officers Amtrak employed as recently as 2015. About a 14% loss over only 4 years. The matter most concerning to us, which is the matter bringing us before you today, is Amtrak CEO Richard Anderson's proposal to further reduce the number of sworn police officers by another 20%, or more specifically, reduce the department by 85 sworn officers and 15 civilian employees. This news prompted multiple questions by the committee, which as of today go entirely unanswered by Amtrak. This reduction will result in police force staffing levels not seen since before 9/11. The reduction in associated hours totals approximately $208,000 per year of lost police protection. If cost-cutting were the legitimate concern of department management, why did it needlessly purchase brand new 9mm handguns this year when it had already purchased new 40 caliber handguns no more than 3 years ago? The department also wastefully purchased new body cameras for a police department that has only been required to use force on an average of 0.9% of arrests within the past 4 years, along with expensive non-lethal weapons such as tasers that have only been used less than a handful of times. Those monies would have been much better spent on repairing and updating our flawed and malfunctioning radio system, which would substantially facilitate inter-officer and departmental communications. Amtrak as a corporation has, simply put, been more concerned with appearances than practical law enforcement and the safety of its passengers. Some recent facts: on March 20th, 2019, Union Station in Chicago was without radio reception for 5 hours. This issue has been ongoing for years. 8 days later, in Sunnyside, New York, a shooting occurred that one officer assigned was able to respond quickly, but there were not enough vehicles at Penn Station for all the officers from Amtrak to respond in a timely manner, which required assistance from the NYPD, who are not familiar with the yard. On April 16, 2019, 18 pounds of fentanyl were seized in New Mexico off an Amtrak train. And May 20 of 2019 in New York, Amtrak police and DEA seized 2 kilograms of heroin and 2 kilograms of fentanyl. In 2015, Amtrak Police Chief Polly Hansen commissioned an independent workforce study completed by a strategic policy partnership. The summary of the report stated, and I quote, "It is also important to note that APD is currently lacking across all regions in actual strength, according to the analysis of the most recent figures available to the project team. This underscores the importance of streamlining hiring process," end quote. Amtrak's plan will shut down police offices on the Northeast Corridor and possibly around the country. This plan will leave stations, trains, and facilities with less than skeleton staffing. The Amtrak community will be left at risk while placing officers in harmful situations. CEO Richard Anderson's police reduction also concerns us for our members' sake as well. The number shown to us on May 1st, 2019 reduces most of Amtrak's police divisions. However, some will be reduced by almost 50% in order to reach Anderson's projected goals. Chief Trugman assured the Labor Committee there would be zero layoffs and furloughs. Amtrak's plan to reduce police force through attrition and a buyout. We don't believe these numbers are attainable. Also concerning, if the attrition plan is unsuccessful, will there be enough transferable positions? How do they plan to reach their reduction goals? We continue to patiently wait for these answers from Amtrak with no response. Also, a major concern is, will Amtrak claim that there isn't enough in their budget for a police department and just make the department disappear? In closing, reducing this police force for any reason is perplexing. We believe Amtrak has a duty to protect its over 30 million passengers and communities it serves, as well as the communities it travels through. It is essential that Amtrak provides a sufficient police force to ensure these responsibilities to the American public. Again, on behalf of the Amtrak Labor Committee, I'd like to thank the committee staffers and members of this committee, and thank you for your service to our nation.